Good morning, dear students. Now today I am going to explain quadrilaterals. Let's start the quadrilaterals. What is quadrilateral? A quadrilateral is a simple closed figure bounded by four line segments. These are the four line segments. It has four vertices, four sides, and four angles. Name, this point we write A, this is B, this is C, and this is D. The name of this figure is quadrilateral A, B, C, D. Now, the types of quadrilateral. Quadrilateral is divided into three: parallelogram, trapezium, and this kite. Now, the parallelogram is divided into two, that is rectangle and rhombus. Then this rectangle is square and the rhombus also gives a square. Create a quadrilateral having both pairs of opposite sides parallel and equal is called a parallelogram. This is the figure of a parallelogram. The opposite sides of AB is DC and the opposite side of BC is AD. Opposite sides are parallel and equal. This is a parallelogram. Now rectangle. A parallelogram having each angle a right angle is called a rectangle. This is the figure of a rectangle. And ABCD is a rectangle in which AB is parallel to DC and AD is parallel to BC and AB is equals to CD and AD is equals to BC and diagonals AC is equals to diagonal BD. And all angles are right angles. This is a property of a rectangle. Now a square. A parallelogram having all sides equal and all angles of right angles is called a square. This is the figure of a square. This is the figure of a square. ABCD is a square in which AB is parallel to DC and AD is parallel to BC. AB is equals to BC is equals to CD is equals to DA. Angle A is equals to angle B is equals to angle C is equals to angle D is equals to 90 degree. Each angle is equals to 90 degree. Now trapezium. A quadrilateral having exactly one pair of parallel sides is called a trapezium. This is the figure of a trapezium. A, B, C, D is a trapezium in which AB is parallel to DC but AD is not parallel to BC. When we extend these two lines, then they meet at one point. They intersect with each other. That's why we say AD is not parallel to BC, only AB is parallel to DC. This is a figure of trapezium and the properties of trapezium. Let's start our exercise 5.7. Look, question number 2. Give reasons for the following. Number A. A square can be thought as a spatial rectangle because under conditions that all sides are of same length, a rectangle becomes a square. Number B. A rectangle can be thought of as a spatial parallelogram because under a special condition that all interior angles are equal and are right angles, a parallelogram becomes a rectangle. Now see, a square can be thought of as a spatial rhombus because that all interior angles are 90 degree, that is right angles, a rhombus becomes a square. D. Squares, rectangles, parallelograms are all quadrilaterals because they are all closed figures and made up of 4 line segments. Number E. Square is also a parallelogram because both have property of opposite sides are parallel and equal, which defines a parallelogram. Square has an additional condition that length of all 4 sides are equal, which make it is a spatial parallelogram. Question number 3. A figure is said to be regular if its sides are equal in length and angles are equal in measure. Can you identify the regular quadrilateral? The regular quadrilateral would be a square because for square all sides are equal in length and angles are equal in measure, that is 90 degree. In homework, write all definitions and solve question number 1 in book.